upstairs, I don't know if you could hear, but they said, hey, can you guys keep it down? We have a show upstairs. And we were like, oh, sorry, you guys have drums. can you guys hear the music from in here? Has it been fine?
Woo!
Upstairs, do we hear it?
No. Not yet.
Wow, so we were laughing outside. I've got this banger of an opening. I'm going to talk about the drums. They've been blasting. It's okay. To make matters worse, I'm not a Sour Patch guy. Over two. Clap your hands if you are a fan of Tolkien's Lord of the Rings. Valar Morghulis, right? For those who don't know, you're not going to get the rest of it either. I love Lord of the Rings. If you haven't seen it or read them, do so. The reason I say that is because this past year I became a member of the Tolkien Society. Yeah, I can repeat myself. This last year, Tolkien Society, prestigious society, it actually exists. And so I was in London last semester because I'm better than you guys. And I went to a bunch of Tolkien Society events, so this story is about my experience with the Tolkien Society, how I realized that I am not on par. They know way more than I do. Because the first event I went to was a lecture at Oxford. So I went up to Oxford. And I mean, I was just feeling it. I got in the room, there's a professor up front, a bunch of hobbits, these British people. I could feel the bond, I feel the electricity in the air, or it's the One Ring present. Right? The lecture was great. So, professor's lecture was the thesis, I guess, was about the pastoral themes of Lord of the Rings. The grazing fields and like shepherding type of stuff is just like rural. And but his thing was, there's all this rural landscape, but there are no sheep. Like, why aren't there any sheep in Lord of the Rings? It's all this rural landscape. And I found out that my knowledge is not on par with where it should be, because when the professor said there are no sheep in Lord of the Rings, a man from the back of the room stood up and said, "Oh, did you check chapter 7? No sheep in Lord of the Rings. I think you skipped the Barrow Downs. No sheep." And the amazing thing was no one else reacted. Everyone else was just like, yeah, that's Ted. Can't slip a reference to livestock past Ted. So, Professor kind of, he's fumbled his way back, but he caught it. Ted was fuming. So, that was the first time I was like, man, you know, I need to read these again with a closer eye. For sure. But, you know, I was feeling good after that one. Then I went to the next event, which was Spring Boot, which was the big, formal, annual dinner. And Spring Boot was a blast. Ask me about it in person, because I'll tell you about it in person. It was very fun. It was funny. So I'll tell you what the nugget of awesomeness that I'll tell you. I was at Spring Boot and just chatting with people. I was the only American student there. And I was chatting with some woman before the formal dinner, and we're just talking Lord of the Rings, and it's great. And she's like, you know, it's your first time here. You know, we have a group that meets bi-weekly, and we always sit together at dinner. If you'd like to join us, and I said, that's awesome. Thank you so much. And she's like, of course, you know, I'll introduce you to the group here. Here's my husband. Next thing I know, I'm shaking hands with the Chapter 7 guy. He shook my hand, and he said hi, and like, little does he know, I'm his biggest fan. That's what he says, is this your first Tolkien Society event? And I froze. I was in eighth grade again, talking to the girl I liked. And I just said, yes, it's my first event. So, you know, he didn't recognize me from Oscar, he had no idea. So he said, oh, well, you should go to more events. We have a lot of great things going on. I said, actually, I was at a lecture at Oxford the other week. And I was like, oh. And he said, yeah, it was pretty good. I said, well, how was it? He said, yeah, it's fine. I was like, ah, he's not going to talk about it. And then he said, you know, but there was one thing. One thing that just wasn't, I don't know how in-depth your knowledge is, the professor's whole thesis was about how there are no sheep in Lord of the Rings when there are in fact sheep in Lord of the Rings. I said, chapter 7, right?